elbows. You come to a squatting position, and you're going to bring your hands down in between your knees. And you want to try to get your upper arms as far down on the shin as possible. Now, you're going to make sure that your fingers are spread and your hands are rooted strongly into the mat. And as you begin to move into crow pose, you want to make sure that you don't lift your tush high in the air. This is how many people end up falling onto their face. Although some forms of yoga do lift the tush high, and it's helpful to do that if you're going to move into Shavasana 2 from the pose, it is not what you want to do in the beginning stages. So what you want to do is to keep the tush low and just roll onto the tops of your toes, keeping, again, the tush low, rooting the hands strongly, and then you're going to really work the abdominal muscles and then lift the feet. From here, you really want to make sure that the abdominals are working and the hands are strongly rooted. So as you roll onto your toes, you use the abdominal muscles and you just kind of stay and enjoy. The tush stays down so you're not going to roll onto your head. And then when you're ready, you just come down and take a break and make sure that the outer wrists aren't hurting, the outer arms are not hurting. So we'll try it again. Come squatting very low, root the hands down, roll only onto the tips of your toes, keeping the tush down, and you can bring one foot up at a time. If this is all you can do, you stay here. Otherwise, you bring both up, and you just breathe and enjoy the strength of the arms and the working of the abdominal muscles. When you come down, you slowly come down, and then rest into child's pose.